It is a dream of hundreds, thousands and lakhs of youths in India to join the prestigious civil services examination and to be a part of that great administration. Do you have that dream? And the same lakhs of people who see this great dream fail in this examination, get eliminated at the preliminary examination, do you also have a fear that you will also fail in this exam? It's like equating, they had the perfect car, they had the driver, it had the almost full tank petrol, but the car still chose the wrong direction. Are you a civil services aspirant like this? And do you have that hundreds and thousands of questions inside you burning? Do you want to start your preparation from the scratch? Then Kickstart is the best session for you. Join the Kickstart initiation and get all the answers, what your preparation, how your preparation should be. Get all the answers in Kickstart. Let's get kickstarted. You've already known how to prepare, how to begin the game. So, next step, the next key step for Kickstart is how to approach your studies. Because there is a lot of difference how you approach. Because the approach that you have to put for civil services exam is also correlated with the changing trends of the examination. That means you have to tune your preparation to the changing trends of the examination. For that, you need to know the trend of this exam. And you must have already analyzed the previous year question papers as a part of the Kickstarter. And you must have noticed one thing, that the trend keeps on changing. The way questions are framed, even from the way questions are framed, from the areas which they ask, there is a big shift in the trend of the examination. And an aspirant who is actually preparing, people, you're all starting your preparation. So you should clearly know what is the target that we are looking up to. So that is why you should know the trend, and only according to the trend, you should fine tune your approach also. And I'll tell you how this works. And take an example. Every topic that you might study, because when you start studying, the ultimate trigger that is going to happen is going to be the time limit. People normally, the civil service aspirants normally has a tendency, they have a tendency to make it quick because the syllabus is so vast and so long, I don't have time. You have to run like an express train. This is an attitude which normally everybody does. Everybody wants to run so fast, they want to be an express train to reach the destination. And what, this is a, first of all, delineate yourself from the race. There is no race happening. There is no race, you're actually competing with yourself. That is the first approach that you have to build in yourself. This is not a race that you do it with certain people. I know you have a lot of things to prove, a lot of things to gain, but this is not a race. Delineate yourself from the race. This is actually a competition within yourself of how much you know. So always at the end of the day, what matters is how many opponents you have defeated. No, how much have I refined myself? How much content have I received? How much of the contents refinement is actually happening inside me? On what level and what scale am I standing? So this basically, this is a reinvention or refinement within you. So that is the first approach. So delineate yourself from the race. Absolutely no race. So what is the point of, you have not given a promise that at this point of time, at this time, this day, I'll reach there. I don't think anybody has given such a promise to anybody. So what matters is, don't run like an express train. This 1 year, use it judiciously. Read the syllabus, read the subjects. So that is why we say, we have coined a new terminology called as MUX-MO. Yeah, MUX-MO is the word. That means mug, save, move. This is what normally I have seen aspirants doing this. And I'll tell you what you mean by MUX-MO. What do you mean by MUX-MO? You read a topic. Okay, this is a topic. This is a topic and you read it, you mug it. That is what the mug means. You just actually read it, the whole thing. You mug it up, you save it, you move. to the another topic. Like this, you move like an express train. You start completing a lot of things. Like, you expect your brain to be a supercomputer to process all the answer without no revision, that one day on the examination hall I'll be able to recollect everything. So don't run. That's why I said, have you given any promise to anybody that on this day, on this particular time, you'll meet someone? No. Mux Mo doesn't work for UPSC civil service exam only because of the changing patterns. The questions paper is highly dynamic. You need to use your critical thinking, analytical skills, and sometimes even a learning from the daily happenings is also asked in the examination. So not Mux Mo. We have coined something called as RUIM, R-U-I-M. That is, read, understand, imprint, move. What do you mean by that? You read, you understand the whole concept, you imprint that thing in your mind, then you move. It's not mugging, saving and moving. Mux Mo can be very super quick. It can be an express train. But RUIM can be a bit slow. But with RUIM, if you start doing the revision, then I'm sure you know the concept. When you study about any particular topic, you study about BRICS, the BRICS summit, you find out what is BRICS, which are the countries involved in this. You read about SAARC, you read about ASEAN, which are the countries which include SAARC, what are the recent happenings of SAARC, what are the recent developments or agenda taken by them. That means you read, understand the whole issue, find out what is it, imprint it, and then you move. Rather than just, SAARC is all about this, yeah, SAARC is this, yeah, I know. That is not the work. So approach is, you're all starting your preparation. No point of running. Ask any topper who has cleared civil service exam, they will tell you that, I knew the concept very well. And only if you know the concept well, in a tough situation where your logic and concept clarity should be there, you can crack it. Or else you only know about things, there is no clarity on that. Ask any toppers, they'll tell you that they knew all the concepts with absolute clarity. That is what we say. Read, understand, imprint and move. You are fresher, starting your preparation. This should be your ideology. Don't run and delineate yourself from the race. Every day, find out how much I have gained, how much I got refined. That is the key important aspect. So this is regarding the prelims also. And whenever you read a subject, whenever you read newspapers also, in current affairs, especially in mains examination, the nature of the questions is shifting. It's highly current affairs based, means previously they ask your opinions. Previously the questions used to come directly. Who is the president? What is the role of the president? Now they might even ask you, the latest model is they might ask you some news about presidents, some of the powers in the newspapers are like this, the governor's rule was like this, do you substantiate this? So they ask questions from the current affairs which has got an implication on the basic static subject. So it's a mix of both. It can be a current affair question, it can be a static question, or it can be a question which can be a mix of both, where your answers will have both current affairs as well as the original content. Now the trend is that, this trend is very important for you in the mains examination as well as interview. It is the new trend of questions which they ask is, what do you think? Do you agree? What is your opinion? Justify. That means they are not asking the static content. They are not asking the current affair issue. They are asking, your answer should definitely have the current affair issue linked to the original static issue plus what do you think. So it is not mucking it up. That means every issue that you read, there is important that you have this thing called as AQ or awareness quotient, not IQ, EQ. Create that AQ or awareness quotient. Create that concept where you have an opinion on everything. Yes, this is my opinion on this. Have that strong opinion on yourself. Because even though it's asked in the mains examination, in the interview, ultimately it's going to be this. What do you think? Do you agree? What is your opinion? If you don't have any of this thing, how do you think your preparation is going to be? So this is what I said. When you approach the examination, these are the pivotal things that should be in your mind. Max Moe, no. Ruim, no speed. Move with clarity. Create an opinion on everything around you. Even if it is an Indo-American issue, rather than just finding out, Indo-American issue is this, these are the points. If somebody asks you, what do you think is India's stand on this? How do you think India is going to benefit from this deal with America? I don't know that, but I know the deal. No. You need to know the pros and cons, your opinion, and this is an issue. What is your opinion on that? Do you agree with this? Yes, I agree with this. No, I do not agree with this. What are the reasons? You should think in like that manner. And please mind it, this thinking process will not happen when you write the mains examination. Or if you're thinking that I'll make this pattern work before the interview, no, this is also not going to work. The point is, such things doesn't come overnight. It needs a lot of time. So you're all fresher starting to prepare for civil services exam. Make sure you have this kind of a orientation in your mind. So, Ruim, no marks more. Think, form opinion, create that opinion formation. This is how you tackle the changing trends of UPSC civil services examination. Try it out. It will work for you.